No one will. Who will stand against our King? No one can. No one will. Oh, oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Him. Oh, 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 victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Him. So who can stand?
finds your light and holds it in her heart. As darkness falls each night, remind her where you are.
Thank you. audience, please feel free to come to the rostrum and you can sit up here with us and make you welcome to this pulpit this morning. The service will now be turned over to our facilitator on today. Let's put our hands together for Pastor Ralph Petty of the City of Grace.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Funeral is over. Now let the celebration begin. Somebody help me celebrate God. This is the day that the Lord hath made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 We do give honor to Christ. Amen. On this day, amen to amen Bishop Wolfie Lee, amen, the proud pastor of this church, the Tabernacle of Life. Glory to God, to Archbishop Michael A. West, Sr., amen, to glory to God, all of these bishops and pastors, amen, to you, Michelle, amen, and this family this morning, amen. I say, glory to God, God is still on the throne. He rules and he reigns, glory to God. And he doeth all things well where his people is concerned. And so we honor him, we praise him, we magnify him, we exalt his name, we lift him high today, glory to God. Because there's nobody like our God. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Well, we're going to do what Chan would do, and that would be praise and worship. Glory to God. Amen. He was a praiser. He was a worshiper. Glory to God. Amen. Many times being over here visiting, and he would just take off running. Amen. And they would turn. Amen. The whole service would turn because of his praise unto his God. Amen. And so we honor the Lord this morning. Glory to God. And we're going to move right along. Amen. But glory to God, we welcome the presence of the Lord. We welcome the move of God in this place today. Amen. We're going to go right to our Old Testament. Amen. Reading from Ecclesiastes. Amen. The third chapter, verses 1 through 8, Pastor Fabian Terry from the First Free Will Baptist Church. Right after that, the New Testament reading, 1 Corinthians, glory to God, chapter 15, verse 51 through 57. Amen. Apostle Kimberly Applewhite, amen, from the Healing Waters Ministry. Following that prayer, glory to God, from Pastor Fred Torres Kenny of the Pleasant Grove, amen, Church of the Koinonia. Let's receive them at this time.
Old Testament reading, Ecclesiastes, third chapter, starting in verse number 1, it reads, to everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to cast away, a time to rend, and a time to sow, a time to keep silent, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time of war, and a time of peace. This is the word of our God. The grass withers and the flower thereof fades. The word of our Lord shall stand forever.
Show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, for we shall be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have peace put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. Oh, death, where is thy sting? Oh, grave, where is thy victory? My God, the sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But
well, God, you have been our dwelling place through all generations. Before the mountain was brought forth, before thou even formed the earth, from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. So great Jehovah, we give you praise in this moment right now, in the name of Jesus. Great Jehovah, we shout out unto you, still with the voice of triumph, in the name of Jesus. To enter to this space this morning. We sanctify this place. We hollow out this room for your grace this morning. We hollow out this room for your healing power this morning. We hollow out this space for your comforting power, oh God. In the name of Jesus, now God, I pray before you, this family of this morning, look and have mercy today. Those that are connected, have mercy on today, God, in the name of Jesus. So, God, we will lead the service. Hear our cry, oh God. Attend to our prayer. From the ends of the earth, we will cry out unto you. When our heart is overwhelmed, lead us. Lead us to the rock that is higher than us. So God, I saturate this atmosphere with Michelle's name now. In the name of Jesus, comfort her in the midnight hour. Comfort her every minute, every second, every hour of the day. And the families and those that are connected, we celebrate the life of ChanMan now in the name of Jesus. So we let the praise continue because you are our dwelling place. We know there's safety in your name. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. If you believe that God hears you every time you pray, can you put your hands together and bless the Lord by answering prayer? Oh, come on, y'all, can you do that? Bless the Lord by answering prayer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We're going to receive a selection. Amen. At this time, glory to God. Amen. To Tabernacle of Light. Amen. And the combined choirs of the ChanMan, they're coming. Amen. This is one of my favorite passages of scripture. Because if you're like me, glory to God, you ran into some stuff in life before. And the psalmist said, hear my cry, oh God. Glory to God. Amen. And I don't know about you, but glory to God, I've lived long enough that every time I cried out, he answered me. Glory to God. I didn't get what I wanted, he helped me through it. Glory to God. So anywhere it went, I still got an answer from God. Let's receive the choir. Hear my cry, oh God.
Thank you.
for thou hast been. He's been a shelter for me and a strong tower from my enemy. When my heart is overwhelmed, glory to God. Lead me to the rock. Glory to God. Amen. All he was really saying was, I got somewhere to go. When trouble shows up, glory to God. Hallelujah. I dare you to look at somebody and tell them, I got a hiding place in God. Hallelujah. And keep you. He is willing.
Glory to God.
call for a resolution. The city of St. Louis, the 11th Ward, Alderman, Alderwoman, please forgive me, Laura Keys. Amen. Let's receive her at this time.
Good morning, saints. For this truly is the day that the Lord has made. And didn't he make it a beautiful day? Amen. So, you know, us believers, we know that there's a book of life. Okay? And this was written in the book of life. So the city of St. Louis has something called a resolution. And it is written in the city's record for all times. I'm here today not only as a representative for the city and the 11th Ward, but this is my neighbor. This child has been in my home. I watched his grandmother in the morning come out when he was a little boy. He couldn't reach the steps. She had to lift him up, put him on that little bus. And so these are not strangers to me. This is family. They know my family for over 40 years. Amen? So I'm going to read this resolution to you. So this is resolution number 183. And so long as the city of St. Louis shall stand, this will be in the record.
Amen.
Whereas it is with deep reverence and heartfelt sorrow that we gather here today to honor the life and legacy of Chandler DeLancey Hill, also known as the ChanMan, an exceptional 18-year-old boy whose presence illuminated the lives of all who had the privilege of knowing him. Whereas the ChanMan possessed a remarkable gift of connecting with people from all walks of life. As he never met a stranger, his warm smile, genuine kindness, and open-hearted nature made everyone feel welcome and valued in his presence. And whereas the ChanMan was a true worshiper whose devotion and faith were evident in every aspect of his life. Through his communication, which was nonverbal, his spirit radiated a profound sense of spirituality and love for his faith, inspiring those around him to embrace their own spiritual journeys. And whereas the ChanMan's life serves as a powerful reminder of the impact one individual can have on the lives of others, his ability to transcend barriers, spread love, and find joy in the simplest pleasures is an inspiration to us all. And whereas the ChanMan had an impeccable sense of style and distinguished dress, his attention to detail and unique fashion choices showcased his individuality, creativity, leaving a lasting impression on all who encouraged him. Whereas the ChanMan had an extraordinary relationship with food, earning him the title of a true foodie, his passion for culinary delights and adventurous palate allowed him to savor the flavors of the world, bringing joy and excitement to every mealtime experience. And whereas the community celebrates the life and legacy of the ChanMan and remember his radiant spirit and his unwavering faith, his unique sense of style, and his passion for culinary delights, and let us strive to embody the qualities that made him extraordinary. Therefore, be it resolved that we honor and pay tribute to the ChanMan on this day. Thank you.
Music Jesus loves him, safe in his arms. Put your hands together, let's applaud the Lord. I'm safe in his arms. Let's prepare now to receive Minister Latoya Allen. She's coming with a liturgical dance. He wants it all.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Bless you. Thank you. Amen. We're going to do this. We're going to have condolences and special acknowledgments, short talks. Glory to God. Amen. And praise the Lord. If you go too long, I'm going to sit right over there. But I'm going to stand up first. And keep going. And I'll just walk and stand next to you. Amen. And then if I do this, give me the mic. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're going to try to, amen, do this and make it through. And then we're going to break it up into two groups. Can I do this? I want to acknowledge, amen, if you're part of the fivefold ministry, amen, that would be apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, amen. If you're a bishop, glory to God, would you stand so we can acknowledge your presence, amen, this morning. You're part of any fivefold ministry, amen. Come on, y'all, let's thank God for being men and women of God. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you so much for coming to share, amen, with us this morning. We're going to do this first. We're going to receive, amen, Progressive Baptist, Missionary Baptist Church. You know, I went to Progressive, amen, and we weren't Missionary Baptist, but anyway, praise the Lord. Amen. We was coaching.
Yeah.
Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Missionary Baptist was on the outside of the church, but on the inside, we was coaching. Amen. Progressive Missionary Baptist Church. Amen. Also, amen, Missouri Institute of Mental Health, amen, Dr. Robert Paul, amen, the St. Louis Book Club, Demons, Judge Nicole Colbert, amen, help me with this last name. What y'all say? Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. We want you to come in this order. Amen. And we're going to move on after that. Let's receive, amen, the Progressive Missionary Baptist Church at this time, following right after also. Also. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's give him a round of applause. This is Dr. Paul, Robert Paul.
I had the privilege of meeting Chandler on several occasions. When he accompanied his mother, Michelle, to the office at the Missouri Institute of Mental Health, most of the time this was in the evening after work. On the weekends, when clearly Michelle and Chandler were giving their personal time to make sure that everyone was taken care of at my age. Looking back, I wish I had taken more time to slow down and lean in and get to know Chandler better and more personally. Going forward, inspired by many of the characteristics that have already been described and I had noticed myself during our visits, I'm very inspired to make changes, to slow down, to listen more, to lead with my heart, to be more kind and more genuine, be more loving, non-judgmental, to slow down and give more of my time to make sure that people around me have what they need. All characteristics I'm sure everyone has noticed of Mom Michelle and Chandler spending time with them. Going forward, this path, guided by the spirit and energy of Chandler, has all the power to change the world. And we love you, Michelle. Thank you for all that you do, and we love you, and we love Chandler. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sister Michelle, Mom, and Jason. It's been challenging to put the right words together, to know exactly what to say in this moment. Most things that came up with seemed dead. No number of words can bring the type of comfort you need. With much prayer and asking God for guidance, I do want to offer scripture to you all. So when the sleepless nights come and the days of wild happens, use this promise from the Lord as your Lord start to come through. Isaiah 41:10 says, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous one. Please know that not only is the Lord holding you, but the book club sisters are holding you and supporting you as well. We're uplifting you. We want you all to know how much we love and respect you, Michelle, Mom, and Chelsea. We hold such great admiration and respect for the way you all loved and cared for Chandler. You all are the epitome of what a village should look like in Agile. You're an amazing mom, Michelle, and we are proud to call you our sister. Thank you for sharing Chandler with us. He was a beacon of light. He was our nephew. Our lives were enriched by his presence. I remember vividly the last time we were all together. We were at Pop Tatum's house, visiting with Katrina. ChanMan sat next to me, and we locked eyes over the tasty treats that were sitting in front of us. We both knew what you would say. He doesn't need anything else to eat. But the ChanMan and I had other ideas about how we were going to commandeer a piece of cake and some fruit. This was our routine every visit. At least one of his aunts was going to make sure he had what he only, not only what he needed, but what he wanted. So, for him, when you left the room, ChanMan gave me the sign.
and kept him in church, this church, and close to God. The last time I visited this church, they invited me because I was still intensely grieving the loss of my sister, your doctor, Susan Corbin Press, my brother, and my mother that I lost in a short span. Michelle was here leading the church with a song, Praising God. Chandler was dancing and praising God. The Lord and Grandma was comforting me as the Holy Spirit was moving us all. I had never felt that way before. Chandler had a personal relationship with God. So when God called him home, he was ready. This place is not our home. He is in a better place. God called his son home, and he was a good and faithful servant. The pain of losing a loved one, especially a child, is unimaginable. Words cannot express the sorrow I feel for your loss. As you all comforted me through grief, I will try to comfort you with the word of God. God promises us comfort for our grief and reunion with our departed. As long as we hold on to God's unchanging hand, please remember to be gentle with yourself during this process and allow yourself time and space to grieve. In Isaiah 61:7, God promises beauty, fruity for our ashes. So keep on the full armor of God and fight. And do not faint, and do not lose faith. Y'all talking good, thank you. Ooh, Lord, okay. I am here, and part of your family village. You both did an amazing job with Chandler. Your gift. Our children are a gift from God. They are on loan from God. You all took care of your character. Chandler is alive in Christ, and we will reunite with him.
Can you please silence your phones?
Chandler's legacy of love lives on. I love you both. Stay encouraged. To God be the glory.
What an honor, what a joy to be gathered here today. This is not a sad occasion. This is a time of rejoicing and giving God thanks for the blessings that he bestows upon each of us. Chandler has paid the earthly debt that's due. You and I still have that debt to pay. So let us come rejoicing with thanksgiving. ChanMan has been in my life all of his life. And I thank God for that. I thank God for his mother and his father, because without a mother and a father, none of us would be here. So we thank God for that. And I'm going to let Glenda speak so I don't get wrong with it.
Praise the Lord, everybody. This is difficult. Michelle, thank you for honoring us and allowing us to be generous God. We didn't have to do that.
And it has indeed been an honor. My Sphinx, that's my name for him. Nobody else can call him that. My Sphinx was a beautiful person who God sent to this earth to show each and every one of us how to love unconditionally. Chandler knew no strangers, and Chandler loved everyone.
Yeah.
And so I am so grateful today for having Chandler in my life to show me the true love of God, not mankind's version, but the true love of God. And so today, as he say, I'll see you again, I can hear Chandler saying to us, because see, he's gone, he's not here anymore. And so I can hear him saying, as I wrote in this thing, oh, I have slipped the Shirley bonds of this earth, and now I dance in the skies on laughter's wings, silver wings. I climb somewhere, and I join the tumbling mirth of sun-split clouds and the angels. I've done and I'm doing things that you have never done before. I've done and I'm doing things that you never thought of before. I sit with my God. And while I may have been nonverbal on earth, I have a voice. And I'm singing with the angels.
This household, Pastor Tori Anthony, amen, Gateway STEM High School, Mr. Michael Fry, amen, and words from the schoolmate, Mr. Bakaway, amen. And we're going to come back and we're going to receive after that our Chandler worship every week, right here in this sanctuary, amen. Tabernacle of life, amen, will come in their own way at that time. Let's receive this household at this time.
Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Nobody else would do with me. One thing that me and Chandler did, we went swimming last summer. I said, Michelle, he said, okay, if I take Chandler, she said, you gonna do what you wanna do anyway, so. Me and Chandler got our stuff together, and we went swimming to North County Rec, and we going in, and if you know Chandler, you know he wanna hold on to you, and I would always say, Chandler, you're a big boy, you don't need me. Okay, for a minute, he let me go, and he connect right back up with me, so. We got in the water, and we walked around, and we played, I walked around, we did about five times, Chandler looked at me and said, I said, what he said? I said, okay, Chandler went and got his stuff. He got out the water, he went and sat down and put his towel over his head, and he was relaxing. And he waited on me to get out, but when we got out, he made sure that we got something to eat. He made, and Chandler, even though we say that he was nonverbal, you knew everything that Chandler wanted. If he sat down at the table, you gave him a bottle of water, he didn't just want the bottle of water, he went and got the packet that he wanted for you to open and put in the packet. Another thing, when you sit down with Chandler to eat, if you don't pray, he's not eating. He's not eating. I would fix Chandler food, sit it at the table for Chandler to eat. I would go in the room and come back and say, Chandler, why are you not eating? He meant that you was going to pray. He meant that you was going to pray. And if he was tired, we could be out all day long. We get home, y'all probably looking at me like, y'all get home. Yeah, Chandler's a part of our house. That's why it's this house over. We get home, we could be doing everything. I go in my room and Chandler in my bed with the cover pulled over his head. Already, I say, Chandler, you gotta go get me your own bed. He had his own bed at our household. Yeah, he had his own bed. Chandler was a part of our household, and Chandler's gonna forever be missed. I believe Chandler was 4 or 5, and he made the connection for our family, and we never knew that it would be what it is now. At 4 years old, Chandler connected. You know, family is something that you're born into, but it's also something that you can create. And Chandler created an unbreakable bond between Michelle, Miss Emma, Chelsea, myself, my wife, and my kids. And all of my family loves Chandler, loves Chandler. Michelle, I just want you to know that we love you. We love you. We love you. And for all of those that's wondering when, it's never ending. It's never ending. It's never ending. So people, well, when? Never. She's at home. She's at home. Amen. I love you all.
Smile through to him. We also have a number of things Tom, I grew up in North St. Louis also, five blocks from where the family lived. West Boston College, I drove that West Boston bus past your home. So 5 years with Chandler. Four of the years, he spent considerable time in my classroom. Let me give you an idea of how a typical day went. You heard Alderman Keyes earlier say that she observed him getting on the bus for everyone. So he would arrive at school approximately 7 a.m. Staff was waiting. A breakfast was served. I was coming from the gymnasium area where I would help bag check more than 1,000 students who went to get away. But I made sure every morning that I would enter the breakfast area and I would greet each and every kid. If I didn't get to Chandler, he'd look around and I'd go get my hug. I might tap him outside the head with him. That plate was full. Love me. Throw that thumb up. Throw it up. Proud. So this school, well, last summer I had a long summer, 4 weeks. 6.5 hours a day. We really got to. Thank God for the help that we have in the public school, especially those who provide ancillary services, speech, language, music therapy. Music therapy was right down the ground. So, he would come to the third period on Monday, Wednesdays, and each other Friday, or every other Friday. That class was an hour and a half. And I would say, can I maintain that focus? I could talk for an hour and a half, but can I maintain the course? So during that first hour of the class, we would give assignments. Chandler would be one of the first to finish. Chandler was one of the first ones to class. Sometimes he would enter before the other class left. I would have to usher him back into the hallway and temper that enthusiasm. Class started, he finished that assignment. He was so slick, as I heard, that he would try to put his assignment in the completed basket before I reviewed it. I would always have to say, Chandler, put that date on the paper. You see that name, Chandler? You never put the date on the paper. But in order to get the reward, in every classroom. And he did. There are areas in the room where we observe for the adults. Comfortable chairs to relax. While they were waiting for instructions to help the kids. Old Chandler was finishing his work quickly so that he could go sit in that room. It was soft, comfortable seats. I had to chase him out of those seats. Other staff members too. But you know, he grew on me. So he got the privilege of that. But the biggest reward was after we spent about an hour, whether it was penmanship, whether it was working one-on-one in small groups, consumer math. We had what we call 30 minutes praise and worship.
Come on.
Praise and worship. We have an 84-inch presentation board in the classroom. We can go YouTube, we can bring up any kind of music, any artist. And I would select certain students. I might have one student go up and bring up a pop artist. Before we can turn around and do the first sound, Chandler is changing. He's going to the board. changing. One of his favorites was Korean orthodox. Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Won't he do it? Chandler loved that song. If I could sing it, I would. Won't he do it? So that was Chandler's biggest reward. Friday before he went to the Lord, he was with me 32. That class started at 10:21, and it ended at 11:59, right before lunch. We had praise and worship. I got up. I went to the front of the classroom. I don't even know what song. But I was along with Chandler. My hands were up in the air, along with Chandler. I pointed to him and I said, Chandler, you're going to be a choir director up in heaven. And my hands started to shake like this. I don't know what took over, but it was Chandler, ChanMan. And that's how we remember him and gave way to him. He was loved, and I'll be very honest with you. There are others who could have come up today and could have spoken to that love. How the parents advocated for him for the best. He got the best. I talked to Mom last week. We talked about some of the distortion in the community in terms of what happened. God knows what happened. We know what happened, but he has risen. He's going to be with the Lord. He's going to sit on the right hand of God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. With those words, I'm at peace. I know he's at peace. Amen. So, I'm going to end. You know, proprietary information as it pertains to special needs students, there's only so much. But I did some digging. I dug all the way back to Knights of Columbus. I dug all the way back to elementary school. I saw names of teachers who serviced him, like Ms. Rogers. I saw those names at various levels. I saw teachers who had worked with him in summer school. One thing that you all may not know, but if I was preaching a sermon today, it would be in pursuit of excellence. 214 students in the graduating class this year. Chandler ranks number 6.
Together. I didn't know at the time how connected we would be and how much we had in common, but we later both attended McKinley Middle School and both of us had our challenges. Our moms were fierce advocates for us, and they are responsible for our successes with help from God. Chandler taught me and other students and staff how to be empathetic, understand others' differences and challenges, and to always be patient. Specifically, he taught me to respect people's differences, be grateful, and use my voice to advocate for others who have no voice. But although he wasn't able to talk, he always put his thumbs up, and he was always there for me. In middle school, I was always bullied by other students, but Chandler was always there. He was always supporting me, whether the kids called me names or whatever, he was always there, and I always felt safe. One of the administrators, Ms. Phyllis Anderson, wrote a book and met with a book club, connected with my mom, Ms. Michelle, and realized how small St. Louis was. When I see his mom, his grandma, I see my mom and my grandmother, who are always there for me and helps raise, protect me, love me, and teach me. They taught us how to love ourselves, to love God, and follow his commandments. We were so blessed to have our grandmothers and our mothers in our lives to discipline us, to hug us, to give their all, and pass down their lessons. I know if he was here, he would say, I love you, Mom and Grandma, and thank you for all that you have done for me. Everything is okay. Thumbs up. Yes, it's okay because he is here in the spirit and he lives in our memories. In closing, I found a poem for his mom and his grandma that I would like to share. Flowers for Mother. I wish you sunshine on your cloudy days, a burst of yellow to pierce the gray. I wish you spring flowers on winter days, a burst of color in the midst of pale. I wish you rain when fields are dry, a blossoming of life where flowers die. I wish you joy every single day and smiles to wash your pain away. I wish you wings so you can fly with the angels in heaven's skies. I wish you the fulfillment of dreams unfulfilled and the contentment that fulfillment brings. My dearest mother, you are. I wish you all that you have wished for me on this and every single day. I wish you flowers to brighten up your day. Thank you.
Journey that you're going through. And I know sometimes, even though I know that you, all of you have faith and you believe God and you trust God, and you know that when you call on him, that he'll answer you. And that he sends his blessings along the way. But there are times when things get a little cloudy, things get a little dark, and the tears start to cloud your eyes. Sometimes it's difficult to see the blessings. But we have to come to a level in our faith in God that when we can't see the blessings, although they're on the way, we have to come to a level where we can hear the blessings. After all, the word of God says, faith cometh by hearing, hearing by the word of God. A songwriter penned this song the other day, and lets us know that when you can't see your blessings, you reach a level in faith where you can hear. You can hear those blessings. Lord, I hear a shout of blessing. Thou art
the word that came into my mind was infectious. And when you think of infection, you don't think positive, but it really was. He was infectious. He spread his smile. He spread his love. There was nothing that Chandler could do that you could just not want to do it with him. When he smiled, you smiled. Then I started to think about Chandler. He's courageous. How many people would walk up to somebody when they're not praising God and make them praise God? that was Chandler. He did it to me. He did. It was one Sunday, Chandler was clapping and praising God, and I was just standing there, just moving side to side. He was like, she ain't clapping. So he took my hands, literally, and started clapping my hands. And so I was like, okay. He walked away, so I stopped clapping. He came back and made me start clapping. So I said, well, until this song is over, I'm gonna clap. Chandler was always happy. He was always happy. He kept a smile on his face. He's awesome. He's neat. His mama kept him clean. From head to toe, Chandler was clean. Chandler was determined, and you all have heard all of the determination stories Chandler's had. Here, Chandler made sure that whatever he wanted, he'd watch his mama in the choir, pay attention to her, and the moment she looked away, he went to the back to grab his water, to ask for whatever he wanted. She would chase him around the church. Chandler was determined that if I want to do it, I am going to do it. He was loving. I used to love to see him sit up and just lay on Michelle. She'd be like, come. He'd be like, lay up on her some more. That is just, like I said, he's infectious. He was excited about praising God. Praise and worship will not be the same now that Chandler is gone. He was resolved to follow and give God praise. If you didn't know, I told you what Chandler was using his name. Courageous, happy, awesome, neat, determined, loving, excited, and resolved. Chandler was infectious. He spread his smile and praise. You could not help but to smile when he smiled. And he would make sure everyone would praise during praise and worship. So let us follow Chandler's example and be infectious in spreading the love of God.
Celebrate the life of Chandler, ChanMan, our beloved member. Hallelujah. First, I want to do these acknowledgments. The family of Chandler DeLancey Hill extend its heartfelt appreciation for the many expressions of love and support shown to us during our time of bereavement. The family also wishes to express our sincere thanks to the combined choirs and musicians for the ChanMan, Easy on the Eyes Photography, Gator Media STL, University of Missouri, St. Louis, Missouri Health Institute, Mental Health, Gateway STEM High School, St. Louis Book Club, Diva, The Crew, This Household, DJ Jimmy Jam, and Mainland Catering. Your many acts of kindness and generosity have both comforted us and lifted our spirits. Hallelujah. I know some of you say this may have been a long time coming, but God's timing is always perfect and is always right. I had two condolences that was handed, they will go to you, Michelle, from the Faith Walkers Ministry, St. Louis, Missouri, 63113. Stacy Harbor, lead servant. And also we have a condolence from Center of Empowerment, 1447 Bird Avenue, St. Louis, Missouri. Overseer Tori Anthony, officers and members of Center of Empowerment, also will give that to you as well. Tabernacle of Life Christian Church, the Church of Empowerment. Hallelujah. We, the bishop, the members, come today to just say that we're going to miss our ChanMan. Our lives have never been the same, and we're not going to be the same, but we're going to always remember everything that ChanMan did. Hallelujah. And the peace of God, we're reminded. Philippians 4:7. And the peace of God that passes all understanding shall keep our hearts and our minds through Christ Jesus. Again, we, your family, Michelle, Mama, Emma, Chelsea, all of us, we have experienced a transition, but God has blessed our ministry, and God will keep us. Our bishop is a strong man of faith, and we stand in faith and solidarity, continuing to pray and lifting up the name of Jesus and honoring God because God is sovereign. He makes no mistakes. Yes, we're going to miss Chan, as you all are, because he's impacted each one of our lives in ways that we can't even explain. For days ahead, we'll smile because we'll remember something that he did or something that he said or a thought. We'll see something, we're going to think about him. But we just thank God for his life. We thank God for the time that he allowed him to impact our lives. And we are forever changed because of that encounter with the Chan Man. So again, we are church family. We'll continue to cover you and pray for you and with you. We're going to continue to love on you through the rest of this process and for the days to come. We know that God, again, is our refuge and our strength. He is our very present help. He is our rock, our fortress, and our strong tower. So we want to say we love you. For precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his faithful servant, Psalms 116 and 15. This is humbly and prayerfully submitted the 30th day of March 2024 by the Tabernacle of Life Christian Church, the Church of Empowerment, Bishop Wilford Lee, our founder and pastor. Thank you, God bless.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. We want to thank all of you for your remarks. We're going to have ministerial remarks. There's a plethora of preachers here today. Amen. And ministers. Lord God, we're going to ask two of you to come. Amen. And to give remarks. Amen. Representing, amen, this great camaraderie. Amen. Of preachers in this room today. So we're going to ask, amen, in this order to come, amen. I see Bishop Deborah Morris is in the room, amen. If you would come to give remarks and follow Bishop Deborah Morris, amen. Let's receive Archbishop Michael A. West, amen, and we'll be ready to move on. After that, I'm not going to come back, amen. I'm going to let you know, amen, the very capable, anointed, amen, man with a vision for this house, glory to God, amen, will be the next voice after Bishop, Archbishop Michael A. West, and will be Bishop Wilford Lee, the pastor and the founder of this house. He's come, amen, to release the word of the Lord. Amen. Let's receive Bishop Morris.
obedience unto God and to his Christ, which is the great head of the church. To my fellow pulpiteers, especially the Right Reverend Dr. Wilfred Lee, and to our presiding superintendent, Reverend Dr. Ralph Petty. To all of you, and certainly you, Michelle, Miss Emma, and all of the family, I greet you with the love and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank God for allowing me to get this old. In a day where youth is applauded. In a day where vim and vigor is applauded. I thank God for allowing me to get to where I am right now. And in my getting there, I am appreciative that he visited me with some degree of wisdom. And when I came in the room today, my mind just began to do so many things and in wearing some hats. But I thought about it, Elder Terry. Good news in the midst of bad situations. Good news. And then I thought about Jeremiah. Jeremiah said, it's of the Lord's mercy. Oh, come to yourself, isn't it? The only reason we're not wiped out is because of his mercy. The only reason we haven't lost our minds with some of the stuff that we've had to go through is because of the Lord's mercy. When you've done all doesn't appear to be enough.
Listen.
And the prognosticators of the gospel of Jesus Christ and the interrogators of the theological community began to cause questions to be raised. Where is God? Where was God? If there is a God. Well, Jeremiah helped me finish this. It's of the Lord's mercy that we're not consumed. Yes. And because his compassions don't fail. Yes. Look over the neighbor right quick. I'm going to leave you alone. Look at the neighbor right quick. Say he's a faithful God. Yes. And because his compassions fail not. Yes. But what about them? They are new every morning. Yes. Every time I need his mercy. Great is his faith. But then, some more good news. Michelle, you've done an extraordinary foreseen. We have been brought here today. But there's gospel that applies. What is it? For God so loved the world. See, when you're thinking, that's enough to shout about. You don't have to rush on to the rest. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. But this is really sharp wording. For whosoever ChanMan could feel the hurt. I'm a spiritual man. Before ChanMan could feel the hurt. Hallelujah. Oh yeah. He said, I took him up and I took him out of here. Shall not perish. Hallelujah. But what is the final verdict? But shall have everlasting life. I was trained in my undergrad years to deal with the types of ChanMan. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. I had a love for folk like him. Because God put him in a special place. And I keep hearing nonverbal, but his actions spoke volumes. Hallelujah. There wasn't a time when I came to this church and stood up to preach. Amen. He would go wild. I said, God, if I don't have anybody else, I got Chandler. It never failed. And he lets you know it. Eternal life, free of limitation. And what do we now say to these things? If God,
well,
shall I say since God, is for us, who could be against us? God bless you. The honorable Bishop Wilbur Lee, amen.
I honor God this afternoon to the Archbishop, Pastor, all the preachers and bishops in the house. Thank you, all of you for your support of this family. I have a couple of things to say, and I won't be long because then I might be. Because ChanMan and I have a special relationship. Let me honor his mother and his father.
Yeah. Yeah.
I salute the both of you for allowing us to experience ChanMan. And it is because of you that we were able to enjoy the wonderful and exciting individual that God entrusted into your hands.
Yeah.
And I'm grateful for that. I'm so grateful that Chandler came this way.
Yes, sir.
And I have to be kind of careful to talk about it because some things you would understand. I know everybody got their Chandler story.
Yeah.
Their ChanMan story. But I want to thank God for his mother that allowed him to live a life that was not constricted by whatever the illness was. A lot of people would have been ashamed. But his mother allowed him to enter into rooms that some of us would never get into. I'm going to scripture, it ain't gonna be long. The only somebody in this church that could help me preach on a Sunday morning was Chandler. Chandler would get up from over there. Sometimes he would run out into the aisle and he would come to me and just stand there and do this. Then some days, depends on how happy he was about what I was preaching, I would be preaching, all of a sudden he'll jump around the church and come stand next to me and do this. He was at some times the only one that understood the scripture. He knew when to shout. It took the other people a delay. He had other people had a delay in action. But Chandler was on cue. And then the others would wake up and say, wait a minute, Chandler running. And let's not talk about the evening board. But when he got his pad, and I don't know what y'all call the pad, and after church, we had to go eat. And if Michelle was to have to stay after church for a meeting or something, he'd get his pad, he'll find me. And I think he had all the apps on there, and he'd go press McDonald's. Or chicken. I said, when he did the first time, I said, Michelle, what is he doing? He'll tell you he wants you to take him to McDonald's. And then he'd say, I said, Chad, I can't take you to McDonald's. I got a good meeting. Then he'll look kind of crazy. Then he'll look at his mom. And she said, well, we get ready to go get something. A lot of people make impact. Now I'm going to scripture. A lot of people make impact, but sometimes it's the wrong impact. Chandler has been known to be a praiser in this house. And he has been the testimony of the teaching of this house. A lot of times you experience him running and lifting his hands and singing a song because he first experienced it in this house in praise and worship. He got so upset one Sunday morning I couldn't preach. He got so upset because the worship team sat down and Pastor Gale had stopped singing. And he just went quiet. I said, what's wrong? And he didn't stop crying and hollering until they started singing again. In other words, it was time y'all sit down. No, he controlled the service when he wanted to. And I let him. And I guess I'm the reason why he was running around my house and everything, because I let him do what he needed to do in order to express himself. I had no problems. And I didn't care about order when Chandler had to express himself. When he would come and stand with me, I wouldn't say nothing. I'd wait for him to say something. He wouldn't say nothing. He'd just do this here, and I'll go ahead and continue to preach. Miss Emma always tried to stop him. She never could. She was never fast enough. And Michelle said, I don't know what I'm doing with this boy. I'm like, I do this your boy. And but in here, he had the free course to do whatever God wanted him to do, whether we understood it or not. So yes, he was nonverbal, but verbal. But I am very grateful, and Michelle can attest to this, that he came into my office and he spoke. I don't know if he said hello. And I said, your voice is so deep. You are grown up. And then every time you would come, I would say, Chandler, you gonna say something? And he'd say, hello. That's a real deep voice. You remember we prayed and laid hands that we would hear his voice. And I stand here as a living witness and the testimony of this prayer house that we heard his voice. So when I just want to stand here and preach over you, friend. Just let me just when I was over at the house, but first of all, let me tell you something. It's not how he died, it's how he lived. I'm not concerned about how he died, because he lived our impactful life, how he lived. So, the nonverbal praise. The nonverbal praise. Psalms 150. You gotta keep, you gonna be for me today. Because we, you know, I'm discombobulated too. But I'm gonna preach.
So, praise ye the Lord.
Just hold on a second. Hold on one second. I know you're ready. Let me finish that. I know you're ready. And Miss Emma used to tell me at home, he'll go around the house preaching like me. You know, she'll call me, you need to come get Chandler. He over here preaching. I said, let him preach. Although he was non-verbal, but he was more verbal than most verbal people. He knew how to connect when it came to God. Unlike some of us who tried to figure out when. Some Sunday mornings he was standing up and start clapping before I preached because he knew the word was coming. You talking about somebody that made it easy to preach, it was Chandler. Some of y'all made it very hard, but Chandler made it easy. The nonverbal praise. And in Psalms 150, it's known to be the final praise. Let's read.
Praise ye the Lord.
Now, that's an action word. You understand? Chandler understood when he said praise the Lord. Half the time he didn't have to tell it. He just knew the time. It's just like that was an internal working on the inside. His spirit man agreed with what was happening, and he would begin to activate what was on the inside called praise. And then it would move to his outer man, and then he'll do his hands like this. See, that means let's get with it, let's get going. I never allowed, again, none of his emotion to distract what I was doing. It distracted Miss Emma more than it did me. And she just reached it, I just let him alone. I know what he's doing. She just want to let him do what he got to do. Praise ye the Lord. That's how come he couldn't listen to everything because everything wasn't great for him to listen to. He was birthed in praise and worship. I think he got around about 5, maybe, or before then. And at leadership conference, he was a mess then because he ran the youth with Miss Ann. And all he know is praise and worship. He didn't know anything else about all the other stuff. Even if he heard the other music, it wasn't interesting to him. I got to experience the spirit of Chandler. Praise ye the Lord. And read.
Praise God in his sanctuary.
Read.
Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness.
Now I need you to stop because I'm getting ready to sit down. Yes, I am. Chandler knew something that we didn't know. Because he experienced something that we never experienced. What are you talking about? How he could communicate and change lives without saying anything. And he understood that it was God that was allowing him to do what he did. So Michelle, dealing with this for the time that you and I have been dealing with this, the Lord began to tell me this. It was only the assignment that had to be completed because the mission had been fulfilled. You hear me? He only had 18 years to do what God wanted them to do. Yes, it's short for us, but one day is as a y'all help me, huh? 18,000 years to make the impact that God wanted him to make in the earth realm. Because if his mission, Michelle, was not over, we wouldn't be doing this. I had to get some resolve. Until we finish our work. Can't go nowhere until the work is finished. I got any witnesses in the house? When I've done the best I can, and my friends don't understand. Because I just needed to know that I heard God clearly. He didn't feel what happened. God will never allow you to finish a mission, then linger you around so you can experience the hurt. Somebody give God praise right now. So when the mission is over, the glorified body takes on the position. Yes, and the scripture bears the record, Pastor McCullough, to be absent from the body. Yes, help me out over there to be present with the Lord. Yes, the scripture bears the record, if this actually house of this tabernacle shall be the God.
My time is up. But before I go,
he had a decision making for you. He impacted our lives by his presence. That's how come in this house, when they didn't want to praise God, I'll come out to preach and I'll say, praise the Lord. They wouldn't say nothing. They do it in your church too. I have to say, praise the Lord three times. They all say, oh, he said, praise the Lord. So, hallelujah. Chandler would say, I'll say, praise the Lord. He's up doing this. Then other people would get impacted about how he was praising God. And then they're joining. And then his praise that provoked you to praise God. Fanette tried to tell it, and I remember that Sunday. The worship team was on fire, and they were ready to take it. Fanette was just sitting there. She looked up like she was crazy. And he went over and got her hands and stuff. I fell out laughing. I was sitting over there and felt like, because he got his hand, got her hands and started making a splash. And then she stopped. He went back and got her hand and made her clap. And then when she kept on, then he gave her the thumbs. In other words, you got it, man. So, how do I resolve? Get me Psalms 34. How do I resolve this? How do we make sense? Because come tomorrow, I have to realize that it's Easter and I look for a well-dressed man. Y'all know what I'm talking about. He will have on a hat. I glory to God. Look forward to the day that he puts on his hat, little necktie, shoes matching shirt, coordinated with the pants, and he was cool. How do we resolve this? It's the Lord's doing. Don't mean I like it. See, y'all need to be honest with yourself. It's the Lord's doing. Don't mean I like it. I got to deal with it. I got to change my mindset. I got to let God heal my heart. I need to let God bridge the gap. I have to tell God to give me a replacement. So, Psalms 34 helps me. This is where it really counts.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I don't like this time, but God deserves to be blessed. Tell somebody, even in this, God deserves a praise. Don't go to sleep over there. You know how I put you in church. Even in this, I got to lift my hands. I got to wave my hands and Father, I thank you for such a time as this. Father, it hurts like you feel in the word, but I thank you for such a time as this. Why you want to thank it? I got a chance to experience of his goodness through ChanMan. I got a chance to understand what it means to give nonverbal praise through ChanMan. I got a chance to experience the love for a son for his mother through ChanMan. I got experience to see ChanMan sit around boardroom tables. Yeah, and know how to act because of ChanMan. Yeah, when ChanMan goes to different meetings that I will be in, he never said a word about what was going on, but I knew he knew. He was never too young to learn what mama was doing. Oh, what mama was doing. In other words, mama never brought him to a place where he couldn't be proud of mama. That's why mama could take him everywhere she went, because she knew she wasn't going to be embarrassed by what mama did. Oh! And if mama wanted to go enjoy herself, she knew how to put Chan and the Chan Man in a place where he still could do what he needed to do while mama enjoyed herself. But mama never brought him to a place of enjoyment that she did. Don't look crazy. Because some of y'all take y'all children everywhere and just let them see everything. But she protected the God on the inside of them. She protected the Spirit of God on the inside of them. She always brought him to education. I'll finish it Sunday morning. So Psalms 150, this is a climactic conclusion to a collection of free praises, praise. When everyone and everything ought to praise God everywhere. That's why you can go to school and want him to do praise and worship. See, some of y'all are ashamed to do it on your job. But when ChanMan went to school, my understanding now, he had to hear praise and worship. I understand what the teacher said. He would change the music. No, not shake cake. He would change the music. Y'all get it. When you in love with God, but all you know is God, all you appreciate is God, you'll change your music. So he knew how to change the music to be conducive to what he liked. He was not conformed to this world. Play me out, because they're looking at me kind of crazy. And right about now, I feel like hollering. He knew how to change the music to conform to his environment. Yes, sir. And he never found himself in the middle of an environment that he couldn't change. What about you? Can you walk in and change an atmosphere like Chandler did? Can you walk in and change a situation like Chandler did? Can you walk in and pray the Spirit of God like Chandler did? I will look unto the hill from which God admires him.
Hallelujah.
I'm a miserable boy. You got to understand, he was the first of my young people to do this transitory business. And I'm so glad I got a chance to deal with it for the years. I had a chance to deal with it. Thank you, Michelle.
Yeah.
Thank you, Miss Emma. But Chelsea, I didn't forget about it, because see, Chelsea had a unique role with Chandler. When he got out of hand, couldn't nobody really bring him in but Chelsea. And Chelsea had a way with him that'll make him quiet down immediately. I don't know what she said to him. I don't know what she did. All we know, when he got to Chelsea, whatever was aggravating him, she made it all right. Sometimes in life, you got to have somebody that can bring you back center. I gotta go. Because we don't have that center in your life, you'll go all kind of ways.
So when Chandler felt like he couldn't get it together, Chelsea first of all would reach for him. And if she didn't reach for him, he reached for her. In other words, he went to where she was. And she, whatever she needed, he knew to calm down. Reminded me when things get overwhelming. And I seem like I can't handle some things. I need somebody to bring me back centered and help me stay focused on what the real. Chelsea didn't have to say anything, but just the fact that he could sit next to her made it all right with him. Just a little talk with Jesus will make it all right. Every now and then, Pastor, you got to have a talk with Jesus so he can make some things. All right. I bless this family. I'm really thinking. Y'all get ready to sing this next song. Brother Bishop, I'm ready for you. I got some things, Anthony, I can tell you this last 2.5 months, the conversation that I've been having and the aggravation I've been having with this boy. I just thank God for the peace that surpasses all understanding. They know how to keep our hearts in our mind. God promised us he'll keep us in perfect peace. My mind stayed on him. I'm not worried about Chandler.
Hallelujah.
Rest well.
Yes.
Sleep easy.
Yes.
Enjoy life.
Yes.
With no restrictions. I'm glad you're performing right now and having a field day in praise and in worship. That what you believe has come into full manifestation. Thank God that you came our way. Thank God that you blessed our soul. Hallelujah. And my thumb is still up, remembering what you have taught us. And your teacher will not be offended. We will always remember your praise. We will always remember your worship. We will always remember your excitement. And we're so glad that we're going to truly remember. Bless you, man. Bless you, man. Bless you. Give God praise. I'm an overcomer. Is that what we are? I'm an overcomer.
Chandler's favorite song, y'all. Praise God.
The death of John Paul II,
they built an altar in front of St. Peter's Basilica. And at the end of the service, they lifted the bier and they went toward the door of the cathedral. When they got to the door, they stopped and they lifted the pontiff up. And the people in St. Peter's Square began to give God praise for allowing the Pope to have come this way. We're not at St. Peter's Basilica, but we're here at the Tabernacle of Life Christian Church. Amen. And I would that you would stand with me all over the building. Amen. First of all, let's give Chandler's praise a thumb up. Amen. And then let's give God a praise for allowing Chandler to have come this way.
Continue to pray for Michelle and his family, his father. We don't want to just think that he didn't have a father. Let's pray for him. Yeah. Any loss of child has an impact on any parent. Pray for our church as we learn a new way. It's a new way for us. Don't talk about us, pray for us. Because we have to learn how to do this without you. So Father, we bless you. We thank you. We honor you. Thank you for this life. Thank you for everything that you're all traveling to the party to the earth. Now as we leave this place, we say now, to keep us from falling, to rinse, to do the exceedingly also, yeah, above and beyond we can ask and think, and also can present us faultless. Blessed we are in our going out and our coming in. Throughout our generations are blessed. Father, we bless this remain even so now. So as we go up under the spirit of praise, worship, love, kindness. We thank you all now. In Jesus' name. Amen.
I'm going to ask that all the casket bearers could be up at the door. All casket bearers at the main door.
Preachers.
Lord, which made the heavens and the earth. suffer, not put to be moved. Even he could be without slumber. Behold, even he that is Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve your going out and your coming in from this day forward and even forevermore. For the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.